In 1948, the footsteps of prophecy began to illuminate the light of truth once again in a world that was darkened since the truth disappeared. According to the prophecy of King David's 40-year reign, the 37-year ministry that Jesus left behind at his first coming had finally begun. However, the gospel field where the truth needed to be restored was a rocky desert where not even a hint of grass could grow. He lived through severe exploitation and oppression from the Japanese colonial period. This led the whole nation to war and left people groaning and living on only grass roots. Christ An Sang-hong, who also lived during this historical era, couldn't avoid extreme poverty and hunger. However, even in the midst of such extreme pain that crosses life and death, Christ An Sang-hong valued keeping the law of life and preaching the gospel as more important than even his own life.
Our faith must never give in to death. To be victorious, we should never submit to this life. In the midst of the Korean War, I did not give in even while in the face of death near the Yunsan Mountains. I never desecrated the Sabbath because of work. I did not spare my life in order to preach the gospel.
During this dark and difficult time, Christ An Sang-hong had to lay the foundation for the gospel. His physical life was poverty itself. Nevertheless, he spent all his hard-earned money for the gospel. In fact, there were many days when he would even skip meals. He fasted and prayed countless times for the salvation of the world, even when in intense pain of death. Pitch black nights deep in the mountains, the cold that was piercing to the bone, fears of the night, and extreme thirst and hunger. Even though the pain of death pierced his body, he did not stop praying while fasting. Instead, he felt heartbroken and pity for the world that does not know the truth. His whole body shattered from unceasing work, just so he may deliver the treasured message of salvation to the ends of the earth. All his scars and wounds piled up on both of his shoulders and became hard as stone.
어느 해 여름에 아버지 모시고 전도를 갔다가 교회로 돌아왔는데 겉옷을 벗으시는데 목 뒤를 보니까 목 뒤에 이 두툼한 손등만한 이런 부분이 부어 있는 것을 발견하게 되었습니다. 그래서 아버지께 아버지 뒤에 목이 많이 부으신 것 같습니다 하고 제가 말씀을 드렸죠. 그랬더니 아버지께서 그냥 웃기만 하시더라고요. 그래서 이제 나중에 이제 말씀을 이렇게 듣고 보니까 돌짐 같은 거 이렇게 나르실 때 두 사람이 이제 목도라는 걸 합니다. 그것을 이제 그 목 뒤로 해가지고 이제 두 사람이 같이 짊어지다 보니까 그 서치는 부위에 굳은 살이 손등만한 굳은 살이 이제 박이셨더라고요. 그 뒤에 부으셨습니다 하고 말씀을 드렸을 때 아버지께서는 그것이 부은 게 아니고 굳은 살이고 그것이 또 훈장이라고 이렇게 또 말씀을 주셨습니다.
Even while his flesh was torn and in pain, Christ An Sang-hong smiled and said, "It's my prized medal for the gospel." How long must your skin be pounded and crushed to form a callus as big as the back of a hand? such rigid calluses prove a life storm of struggles he must have endured. With the wages from his hard labor, he would buy pens and notebooks to write the truth books of life. He also prepared preaching expenses to find all his children in remote areas at the ends of the earth. He stayed up all night writing the books of truth under a dim burning lamp. He pressed down on every page of prophecy with his heart full of love and sorrow towards his lost children.
Therefore, how much effort has God put into saving us? We need to think about it deeply. God spares nothing to give us practical lessons.
그 영광 받으셔야 될 하나님께서 이렇게까지 참 고생을 하셨구나 하는 생각을 하니까 그렇게 노동해서 번 돈으로 교회를 꾸려오시고 책자 쓰시고 이렇게 해서 오늘에 또 우리를 구원의 길로 인도를 하셨구나 생각하니까 마음이 굉장히 좀 울컥하는 어떤 그 내용도 있었고 마음이 굉장히 참 짠했습니다.
It wasn't because Christ An Sang-hong was uneducated that he lived such a difficult life. To set an example of keeping the Sabbath under any circumstance and to provide expenses to find his lost children, he took on dangerous and rough jobs. But he was ridiculed, despised, and avoided by others. Only the hardest work in the world was left for Christ An Sang-hong. Though he himself had no clothes and was in constant hunger, Father did not spare anything for his sons and daughters. His children are what gave him strength to walk the thorny path of death and to endure excruciating pain. Christ An Sang-hong proclaimed the new covenant all throughout his life for his children and restored the precious feast of life. And in the 37th year, at the end of his mission during his second coming, he had already testified through the media that he would leave after completing the prophecy of the 40-year reign of David's throne.
The second coming Jesus has to come to the earth in secret and pass away after preaching the gospel for 37 years.
He told his disciples ahead of time that he would leave soon. And he quietly let them prepare the way for the gospel.
다녀가시는데 그 모습이 여느 때와는 완전히 좀 많이 달랐습니다. 굉장히 많은 어떤 그 근심과 걱정 또 앞으로 어떤 교회에 대한 어떤 그 염려에 마치 십자가를 내일 지셔야 되는 어떤 전날 밤의 어떤 그 예수님의 그 모습처럼 그렇게 어느 때 보더라도 아버지께서는 늘 참 편하시고 온화하시고 다정다감하신데 그날만큼은 너무 이렇게 말씀도 없으시고 근데 이제 아버지께서 내가 두 팔 두 다리를 다 모서도 끝까지 믿음을 저버리지 않고 따를 수 있겠느냐고 이렇게 말씀을 주셔서 저는 이제 복음을 하면서 아버지의 그런 어떤 그 질문을 또 처음 이렇게 당하다가 보니까 굉장히 놀랐습니다. 다시 말해서 육체의 어떤 그 올리우실 것을 미리 이제 그 말씀을 하시는데도 그걸 이제 빨리 캐치를 이제 못했던 겁니다. 이제 끝까지 따르겠습니다 하고 어떤 상황이 되더라도 어디로 인도하시든지 이제까지 우리가 배운 것이 가르침 받은 것이 그것인데 어디로 인도하시든지 따라야 되지 않겠습니까 하고 그 말씀을 하시니까 고개를 끄덕끄덕 하시더라고요.
Christ An Sang-hong restored the truth of life that had been destroyed during his 37-year ministry. He taught the light of truth of the new covenant with constant love and devotion. Even at this moment, this light of life still illuminates and saves the whole world.